Please open Android Studio. Here. Click on Open, and then this is the project we have been working on. If you look here, you will see the Android folder under the project. Please select the folder and click on Open. This will open the Android project within the React Native project we have been developing. Here, the Java package. Name is mentioned, and the current package name is set to com.serial.com. Please open the main activity here. First, what I'm going to do is override the function called onCreate here and add the code to keep the screen from dimming. When you call onCreate, it essentially automatically overrides when you do it like this. Here, by using get window add private home manager layer. Param, keep screen on. The screen will remain bright and not dim. Next, I will create a variable function called private void hide. Final view. Here, I will use flags to set some UI configurations for the screen. And I can merge the flags that I am currently using in order to ensure that the necessary and appropriate settings are applied correctly and efficiently to the system. You can merge. First, you will set the system UI flags, layout stable, which ensures that the layout remains consistent and stable across different UI changes. Then, you will module the view, system UI flags. Layout hide navigation, which hides the navigation bar to provide a more immersive experience. Additionally, you will set the view, system, UI flags, layout full screen, which allows the application to utilize the entire screen space, and view system UI flags, hide navigation, which further ensures that the navigation bar is not visible. Furthermore, you will apply the view system UI flags, layout full screen, once more, to reinforce the full screen mode. You will also include the flags for system UI, flag full screen, which is crucial for applications that require full screen usage, and system UI, immersive sticky, which allows the user to temporarily reveal the system bars with an inward swipe. These flags are merged with the settings to create a seamless user experience, and then you will use window.get.decode. Set system user UI visibility to apply these flags effectively. There may be cases where the status bar is still visible, and for those cases, you can apply set bar color transparent to make the status bar blend with the application background. By calling this function, the navigation bar and status bar will be hidden, and if they cannot be hidden, the status bar will be made transparent to maintain the application's visual integrity, which is crucial for applications that require full screen usage and system UI. Immersive sticky, which allows the user to temporarily reveal the system bars with an inward swipe. These flags are merged with the settings to create a seamless user experience, and then you will use window.get.decode. Set system user UI visibility to apply these flags effectively. There may be cases where the status bar is still visible, and for those cases, you can apply set bar color transparent to make the status bar blend with the application background. By calling this function, the navigation bar and status bar will be hidden. And if they cannot be hidden, the status bar will be made transparent to maintain the application's visual integrity. If it has been reactivated, you should set it up so that the hide navigation bar is executed again, just in case the status of the navigation bar is displayed due to another app or different environment. Please close the main activity. Then right-click here and select Java class from new. After that, I will name it Boot Receiver. Once you have received the item, carefully inspect it to ensure that all components are present and in good condition. This step is important to confirm that the item meets your expectations. To ensure that your application runs automatically when the device boots up, you need to create a broadcast receiver. This involves inheriting from the broadcast receiver class and overriding the onReceive method. The onReceive method is crucial because it handles the intent that is broadcast when the device is booting. In this case, the intent I is used to capture the boot event. By creating this receiver, you ensure that your application is notified and can perform necessary actions when the device starts. First, you need to create the receiver class. This class will act as a listener for the boot event. Once the class is created, you must register it in the Android manifest file. The manifest file is a critical component of any Android application, as it declares essential information about the app to the Android system. To register the receiver, open the manifest file and add the necessary permissions. Specifically, you need to add the receive boot completed permission. This permission allows your application to receive the boot completed broadcast, which is sent when the device finishes booting. Next, within the same application scope in the manifest, after declaring your main activity, you need to declare the receiver. Name it boot receiver for clarity. This declaration should include an intent filter that listens for the boot completed action. An intent filter is a powerful feature in Android that allows components to register their interest in specific events or data. Here is an example of how you might declare this in the manifest. XML. By doing this, when your application is installed on a device and the device is subsequently turned off and then back on, the boot receiver will be triggered by the boot completed event. This event is sent by the system once the device has finished booting. If you are deploying this application on an embedded device, this setup is particularly useful. Embedded devices often require applications to start automatically without user intervention. By implementing a boot receiver, your application will automatically launch whenever the embedded device is powered on. This ensures that your application is always running and ready to perform its task as soon as the device is operational. In summary, creating a broadcast receiver for the boot event involves several steps: inheriting from the broadcast receiver class, overriding the onReceive method, registering the receiver in the manifest, and adding the necessary permissions and intent filter. By following these steps, you can ensure that your application is spawned to boot event and can start automatically when the device powers on.
And just like we did earlier, in React Native, main activity is actually one activity. Now that main activity is attached, the screen brightness is maintained continuously, and then with hide navigation bar, if you look at the actual top and bottom navigation bar and status bar, it looks messy. It's messy, or customers can control it. So I've reflected those things in the code by hiding them in a way that is effective. This time, I explained in detail the necessary settings and additional configurations for using the app for a kiosk. As I mentioned earlier, this includes maintaining screen brightness, removing the status bar at the top and the navigation bar at the bottom, and setting up the code so that the app automatically runs when the device is booting in order to ensure it operates efficiently and comprehensively. There may be slight differences in this depending on the embedded device. When using that device, you need to slightly consider its specific characteristics. We need to take a look at the configuration properties. So, I can't say that this will work perfectly 100%, but generally, if you set it up this way, it should function as I mentioned. Then, I will see you next time with another topic.